come up with the idea for this?
So it's filled with slime. And I love chemistry, and slime is like a classic chemistry experiment slash toy slash amazing thing to play with. But I wanted to take it to the next level because there's lots of slime kits out there. And then I came up with this idea of like, what if we could have like an instrument sort of that's powered by slime?
Yes, I've heard it's very musical.
Yes, it is. All right, hit the button for a box.
Before I begin, I'm gonna cover my surface with this mess mat and put on some gloves to help things stay clean and from getting chemicals all over the place. We are going to make two types of slime, and the first one is jelly slime. First, I'm going to add all of my baking soda into the beaker. Pop off the cap and peel the foil from the slime activator. I'm gonna go ahead and pour in only half the slime activator. I can see the halfway point right here on the bottle, but it doesn't have to be perfect. That's about half. Then just give it a quick stir. It's not gonna all dissolve, and that's okay. We just wanna give it a nice stir. Okay, I'll take the cap off the glue bottle and remove the foil. All right, let's pour the rest of the slime activator into the glue bottle. All right, let's mix in our color. Alex, I want to make an orange slime. How can I do it?
Oh, neat. Okay, so to make an orange slime, I would recommend 3 drops of red and 3 drops of yellow. But the more color you add, the more vibrant the color is going to be, until you add so much color that it's really dark. So start with just a few drops, mix, see if you like the color, and add more color if you want.
Awesome, will do. I wanna make an orange slime. Alex told me to add 3 drops yellow and 3 drops red, but to start small first. So I'm gonna start with just 1 drop yellow and 1 drop red. All right, I'm gonna give that a stir and see what it looks like. All right, with my 1 drop of each color, it's looking a little light. I think I want it to be a super vibrant orange, so I'm gonna add, let's say 4 drops yellow and 2 drops red. Let's mix it up. All right, now that I have my perfect neon orange, let's keep mixing things up. We're about to make a chemical reaction happen. Let's go ahead and add this glue to the beaker and give it a stir. And stir. Ah, look at that. It's becoming slime. Whoa, look at that. That happened so fast. Ooh, okay. I can tell there's still some baking soda at the bottom, so I'm gonna stir it more, but it's getting a lot harder. All right, so I've mixed it a bunch. You're gonna wanna do it at least 5 times, and it's not gonna be perfect. There's gonna be liquid in the bottom, but now I can take it out and get my hands into it, which I am super excited about. Ah! That feels very cold. Okay. Ugh, it's sticking in the beaker. Okay. It's gorgeous. Perfect neon orange. That feels awesome. Ooh, you hear it? Ooh, perfect. It's getting even slimier the more I mix it around with my hands. I'm gonna dunk it back in just to get a little bit more of that slime activator on it. All right, I'm gonna pull it out again and stretch and fold together at least 5 times. Let's stretch. And pull together, stretch, and pull together, just to make sure it's nice and mixed. Ooh, gets harder every time. Cool, okay. It's coming together nicely.
All right, let's do the stop and check. Is your slime still sticking to your gloves?
Nope, I think it's pretty solid.
Yeah, it looks great. So if it was still sticking to your gloves, you should go back and repeat steps 10 through 11, because basically the slime just needs a little bit more activator to get into this perfect consistency. But yours looks great.
Yay. Now that I have my slime, I'm gonna split it in half. I'll put half of it into a container for later. As for the rest, let's turn it into gummy slime. So with half my slime, I'm gonna smush it down to poke a hole in the middle. And then I'm gonna add about half the cornstarch to the middle and wrap it up. Now I'm gonna stretch and fold the slime to mix in my cornstarch. Alex, what does this cornstarch do to the slime?
The cornstarch thickens it. So that basically is what is turning your jelly slime into gummy slime. You'll see that it's gonna be a little bit of a different texture once you have this all mixed in.
Fold it up. Oh. That is okay. Let's just keep mixing it up. Stretch and fold. I can already feel the texture changing. And with the cornstarch that burst out, I can still use it. I'm just gonna roll and press it into my slime. All right, now I have my gummy slime. It's kind of breaking up a little bit more than my jelly slime, and the texture is a little bit thicker, which is cool. And I'm gonna go ahead and put it in my container so I can use it later. All right, Alex, I've made us some slime. Here you go.
Wow, I really like the color.
Thank you. I love how this one turned out like mac and cheese.
Yes, delicious. There's a ton of fun things you can do with this. So like, they're really stretchy. If you go really slow, you can go really far.
Slime pull.
Ooh.
You can take it across the room.
Yeah. But it's kind of neat, because if you go slow, you can pull it really, really far. Or if you go fast, it just breaks.
Uh-huh.
Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
So the slime is also, so it's stretchy, but it's also really bouncy. So if we put it into a ball, we can bounce them. Bam!
Yours is bouncier than mine.
Yeah, the gummy one gets really bouncy. Also, since we have the cornstarch in this one, it's a different color. But if you stretch it, try making yours into this like cool wiggly window. I see you!
Okay.
That's awesome. All right, let's make some music. For that, let's make your sound machine.
First, stick the piston inside the tube. Heads up, the O-ring might be a little oily, so just be careful. Next, screw on the cap. Now I'll attach the wooden ball to the yellow piston. And now I need these two pieces to make my valve. Fit the valve into the nozzle. The pointy end should be down while the wide end is up. Let's stop and check for a second. I just want to make sure that this wide end here is on the same side as the screw threads, and this opening is where the pointy end is. I'm going to attach the valve to the piston and twist in. Okay, now I'm going to need my base and my slime from part one, either the gummy or the jelly, but I think I'm going to go with the jelly to start. I need to get it into the base, so the easiest way to do that is to just stretch it and let it droop in. Stretch it and let it droop in. Next, I'll attach the gasket to the base like this. Make sure those holes are lined up. Now I'll place the cap on top of the gasket and twist. And now let's put everything together. I'll add the tube to the base and push the nozzle down into the slime. Now to finish our sound machine, I'm going to put the speaker cone on here. And once it's secured on, I've got to have wiggle eyes. Cool. Gorgeous. And just like that, my sound machine is done. Let's make some noise. All right, are you ready to see my build?
I'm ready.
Ta-da! Here it is.
It's beautiful. Make
Thank
it
you.
Go. Oh,
yeah, there yeah. we go, there we go.
Yeah. Yes. Awesome. So as you're playing with it, sometimes you'll notice that the sound might get a little bit weaker or almost not there at all. It's still going pretty strong, but if you're not getting any sound, basically what's happening is you're not trapping the air enough. So the slime needs to be able to trap the air in order to make that noise. So all you gotta do is lift this up a bit and move it around. Just press that slime back down, maybe put it at a different angle. There we go. Yeah. So basically the rule is just move it around, push that slime back down.
All right.
So if you're noticing that this is too hard to press and it feels like something is catching on the inside, the O-ring is probably catching on the outer wall. So there's this dark blue O-ring on the inside. Just add a little bit of cooking oil on there and that'll help it move nice and smooth. If the pump gets clogged, there's probably some dried slime in here. So that's why we have this piece as a separate piece. You can just unscrew it. You already see these little slime bits coming out. And then there's this special valve here. Take that out. Then you can clean out any dried slime that's in there. Slime bits. And then just put it back together. That's why this nozzle is here in the first place, is to protect the inside of the pump. If your slime has dried out a little bit, all you have to do is add just a little sprinkle of water. Just a little bit. And then mix it back up, bring that slime back to life. Oh yeah. So there are a ton of different ways to play with this. You've already seen like the wide range of noises you can make by like moving it around. You can also play with like fast pump versus slow pump versus like more powerful pump to make like the wide range of noises that you can do. You can also place it on top of different surfaces. Like if you place it on top of a bowl, it'll like reverberate really cool, like add a speaker essentially to your slime powered machine. But I was kind of thinking another fun way to play would be if we created our own fart symphony. You want to try?
I would love to try a fart symphony.
All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
Da na 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 na.
Da 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 da. Thanks so much for building along with us today. For more videos, be sure to subscribe. There we go.
Bye.
Now all I need is a box. Oh, and I do it. Okay,
hit the button.
Just hit the button for
I want to blow a bubble in.
Do it, do it. Whoa!
Ha ha ha!